Hey everyone, I'm meteorologist Matt. So we're updating on what you can expect as far as rain goes as we go through the remainder of Tuesday. We've had a little bit of light rain from time to time in downtown Omaha so far this morning, but really the steady rain has been off to our west for the moment. Temperature at the airport, 65 degrees. Winds, they are gusting out of the south, sustained between 15 and 20 miles an hour, some gusts over 30 miles an hour. We'll keep those gusty winds going as we head into the afternoon. Pressure, 29.73 inches of mercury and falling. So you can see that pretty strong area of low pressure is winding up just to our north. There's the light rain still continuing over Omaha, some steadier pockets moving toward Trainer and Oakland in Pottawatomie County. But as I zoom back out, you can see that heavier rain has continued through most of the morning, anywhere from York to David City, Columbus. Finally, those three cities are starting to dry out, but that heavier rain is pushing toward the Clarkson area, Hooper, West Point, up toward Wisner and Pilger as well. Next batch of rain coming in from the south, getting wet toward Beatrice, Auburn, Nebraska City right now, but that's going to be lifting into the Omaha Metro as we go into the middle of the day. So make sure you still have that umbrella close at hand if you're going out for lunch. Here's the bigger picture. You can see things starting to wind down a little bit off to our west. However, there's a cold front and another area of low pressure coming out of Kansas that will kick off more showers and storms as we go into the late afternoon and evening. First to our west, and then getting toward the Missouri River. Severe weather potential as it pops in there. Slight risk of severe weather from Omaha to the south as we go into the late afternoon and evening. The marginal risk in the green across the remainder of the viewing area. Damaging winds and large hail will be the most likely if we see any severe weather, but I can't rule out an isolated tornado just because there's a lot of spin in the atmosphere, especially you can feel those strong south winds. Winds aloft are a little more west, so you get that easy spin as you go up with height. So that's why we could see that brief spin up, but it's really not a big tornado threat day across eastern Nebraska and western Iowa. Storm predictor, this model run doing a great job showing that next batch of rain lifting into Omaha as we go into the middle of the day and then pushing into western Iowa into this afternoon. 3 o'clock when the kids are coming home, maybe a brief rain shower here in the metro. Better chances for rain when the kids are coming home from school across western Iowa and then back to the west along the cold front. As we head toward 5 o'clock, more thunderstorms firing up along that cold front. Omaha's evening commute, it should be okay. Maybe a spotty shower here or there. You can see that first batch of storms kind of reigniting a little bit more with the higher sun in western Iowa. Look at this evening. After 6 o'clock, those storms will be knocking on the door in Omaha, moving through by 9. That's the line of storms that could be severe, and it'll push into western Iowa anytime after about 8 o'clock, getting done by 11, and then quieting down overnight. So it's a really small window where we could see those big storms this evening. Already, anywhere between 1 and 1.5 inches of rain in Norfolk, Columbus, David City, York early this morning. With the next round of storms, we could be looking at totals anywhere between 2 and 3 inches locally, and that does include parts of the Omaha Metro and in western Iowa. Widespread amounts approaching an inch, certainly almost seem likely at this point. So it's going to be windy, highs around 70 this afternoon before the storms come in this evening, and then everything quiets down tomorrow. We get a day to kind of recuperate with highs in the mid-70s and a lot of sun, but then the rain moves right back in on Thursday. Maybe a very low potential for some severe weather on Thursday, but additional heavy rain so quickly would not be welcome across eastern Nebraska and western Iowa. So again, just that light rain, maybe a few rumbles of thunder as we go into the early afternoon, but it's late this afternoon and into the evening where we could be dealing with some stronger thunderstorms. Download the KETV mobile app. It's a free download. Great way to stay up to date with the latest on the weather conditions as we go through later today and deeper into the upcoming winter season. But you have the interactive radar on the app where you can track storms down to your street, plus the position-based storm alerts. So your phone, no matter where your phone is located, it'll get an alert saying, hey, there's severe weather in the area or there's lightning in the area. So go get that this afternoon if you don't have it. Chief Meteorologist Bill Ramby, of course, will be in later on today. I think his sleeves are staying down, so don't get too excited about that. And I'll see you guys tomorrow morning on First News.